Wait, have we just breached our internationally agreed climate target? And what does this have to do with it?
January 2024 was the hottest January on record. That's according to new data by Europe's climate monitoring service, Copernicus. And in fact, every single one of the last 8 months has been the hottest on record for that particular month. Copernicus says that average global temperature anomalies, so the difference above normal, was 1.5 degrees above pre-industrial levels for nearly half of the days in 2023. And you might remember too that 2023 saw the first time that temperature anomalies reached 2 degrees above pre-industrial levels. So it should come as little surprise then that we've just officially reached the first 12-month period where global average temperatures are 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels. This is devastating news, and it illustrates how quickly and how comprehensively we have changed our climate. And it should be a real wake-up call. There is no corner of the planet that is untouched by human activity. There were extreme events of every type on every continent last year. Antarctic sea ice completely nosedived, and ocean temperatures are still astoundingly high. This news marks another milestone in the history of human influence on the climate. If you watched my last video, you might remember me saying that global average warming is around 0.25 degree away from that 1.5 degree Paris climate agreement target. And on the surface of it, this news might appear to contradict that. But you may also remember that the Paris Agreement target refers to a longer term average, which means that temperature anomalies will have to remain 1.5 degrees above pre-industrial levels for more than 1 year to reach the threshold. And in fact, as you can see on this chart, Copernicus's data for January 2024 shows that warming has reached 1.26 degrees Celsius, which actually agrees very nicely with this paper by Rich Betts, which I got my estimate from. As we inch closer and closer to 1.5, and as the evidence stacks up about how completely we are screwing the climate system, it becomes ever more important to know exactly where we stand. But that isn't necessarily that straightforward. Recently, I've heard lots more things like we've already reached 1.5, or that data are being suppressed, or that climate scientists are moving the goalposts on purpose. But I think rather than being evidence of some dodgy underhand behaviour or some kind of climate cabal, all of this confusion can actually be explained by some pretty boring technical details. In climate, a baseline is a period of time against which we compare temperature change. And when we measure progress towards a particular target, say 1.5 degrees, we need to make sure we're comparing apples and apples, or oranges and oranges. The Paris target and all the discussions around climate impacts at 1.5 or 2 degrees that are conducted by the scientific community and then synthesized by the IPCC use the 1850 to 1900 baseline. So what's considered a safe level of warming is measured against that benchmark. If we use an earlier baseline, then more warming will be required to reach the same threshold of impacts. And this is exactly the point that matters for a study that ruffled a few feathers recently. They used some really old sea sponges to reconstruct temperatures right back to 1700. And then they used that to suggest that we have reached 1.7 degrees Celsius of warming, and so blown through our Paris Agreement targets. Sounds pretty scary, right? But the problem with this study is that they were using an earlier baseline to calculate warming. So any comparison against the Paris Agreement targets was comparing, well, apples and oranges. Don't get me wrong, I love apples and oranges, but they're just not the same. Look, it is great to find out about warming prior to 1850, and in fact, scientifically, it's essential. But expecting that data to be able to tell us something about whether or not we've exceeded the Paris Agreement targets misunderstands what that target actually is. Ultimately, none of this changes the simple facts. We need to take action, and urgently. As put by the Deputy Director of the Copernicus Climate Service, Sam Burgess, rapid reductions in greenhouse gas emissions are the only way to stop temperatures increasing.
I'm in Berlin right now, but back home in the UK, both our government and the opposition are rolling back their commitments to take action on climate change, which is exactly what we don't need. This news shows that we need more action on climate change, not less. Because unless we do something about it now, the kind of headlines we saw in 2023 about floods and heatwaves and wildfires and droughts and extreme rainfall will be barely newsworthy anymore. Extremes will be way worse. People are already losing their lives, their livelihoods, and their homes. And that's only going to ramp up. It could be any of us next. So wherever you are, I urge you to push your government to do more and join up with other people to be part of the solution and part of the fight back. As the great Catherine Hayhoe always says, one of the best ways to tackle climate change is to talk about it. So if you like this video, give it a like and a share. And if you want to support the channel more, you can become a patron over on Patreon. But if you'd rather stay here and watch more videos, then why not watch this one about why I think 1.5 degrees is still a worthwhile target. Okay, see you next time.